I Googled it one day. I was like, 1917 Academy Award winning World War One movie. How do I watch? And I ended up on Reddit, and this guy's like, hey, I've uploaded the movie for free. Click this link. And I clicked the link, and it took me to Pornhub. Because you can just do that. You can. I thought that would stop it. I don't know why. I thought a government or maybe a fact checker at Pornhub. I thought someone was on the back end watching the videos come in being like, this isn't horny enough for me. Get the out of here.
Would you please put your hands together for Sam Taunton? I'm not sure I believe that explanation about how you got there.
What, I mean, you think I was just trolling, doing my normal thing on... No, it's true. It's still there. If my mum's watching this, so it's a lie, clearly. No, but I did it, and then afterwards I thought, you know, because I'm a stand-up comedian, you know, I want to get my name out there, so I thought maybe I'll put some of my stand-up comedy on porn websites.
What?
So I'll be like, I'll be the most famous comedian alive. So I went to do it, but there is like a process you have to do. You have to sign up to become like an adult model. So I started filling out the porn, and I was like, this is a slippery slope to me becoming a porn star. So that's where it ended. But for a moment, I was going to be a big player on some of those websites.
The truth, I think we need to see your browsing history. Yeah. But...
No. I'll go. Well, I've just leaked my data, so it's probably all out.
Did they really?
Yeah, my passport's gone, so there's a lot of Sam Tauntons out there right now.
Well, we've got the real one, which is a great thing. And you've got a big show next month in Newcastle, a live taping of your show live. So you obviously have a big connection to Newcastle.
Well, Lisa, you would think that. I'm not from Newcastle, haven't spent a lot of time in Newcastle. It could be one of the worst decisions I've ever made to perform. My agent was like, I wanted to film some stand-up, and they were like, where would you like to do it? Normally, people would say Sydney or Melbourne. I was like, Newcastle. And it could be a mistake. I'm a big fan of the band Silverchair, and they recorded, like, a live album, and it was awesome. I love it a lot. But what I forgot was that they're from Newcastle, yes. And at the time, they were one of the biggest bands in the world.
Yeah.
So I'm expecting, like, five people to come to my big recording in Newcastle. So it could be a real big issue for me.
Will we be able to see this taping on Pornhub?
Well, you keep watching Pornhub, maybe you'll see it. I'm looking for Sam. He's got to be here somewhere.
But, Taunton, obviously, the other thing you love about Newcastle is it's a sort of a regional centre.
True.
Regional city.
Love a regional.
You love a regional town. Yes. I know this because I know that you actually know the population of any regional town in Australia.
No.
Hing sold this to us as this is his party trick.
It's a party trick.
This is
I've written down.
Once at a dinner party, I was on a hot streak of naming the populations of, like, towns in Australia. And this is the gossip mill. Now I'm on national TV and I feel like everyone asked me populations of towns. Here we go. YouTube fail compilation of just the dumbest guy ever.
All right, Broken Hill.
Oh, okay. I'm going to say like 22,000.
Oh, you're a bit high. Bit high.
What, 18,000?
Yeah, it's 18.
Okay. That's pretty good, right? That's real good. Right, people in Broken Hill wouldn't even know that.
Karratha in WA.
Oh, okay, so it's had a big boom recently. I'm going to say quite... No, it has because of the mining area. I'm going to say, like, 18,000.
Opposite. You were right. It was a bit higher than that.
It was 20, like, early 20s.
Yeah, early 20s. Yeah.
Okay. I'm a great dinner party guest.
What is the population of Newcastle?
Okay, combined with, like, the Maitland area... It's like about 500,000. I want to say it's the eighth biggest city in the country.
Hey, you know, it's wild.
Yeah, I'm a real inviting round, guys. I'm a cool guy. I'm a real interesting cool guy.
And you did that trick, I'd think it was really hot.
Yeah. Tell that to my girlfriend because she doesn't think it's very hot.
So you recently performed in Edinburgh.
I did,
and then afterwards you and a whole heap of Australian comedians got together in a big mansion.
Yeah.
And just had like a... What did you do? You and a whole heap of dirty comedians.
This already sounds like a reality TV show.
I was going to say, it sounds more like that website.
Yeah. Funny stuff. No, a lot of people think comedians, like, hang around, it's all wacky, like we're, you know, pulling pranks, but we just kind of hung around, talked about some blogs we'd read recently.
Blogs, were they?
Blogs. Yeah. Well, anyway, I wanted to go to Spain because I'm trying to learn Spanish. My girlfriend's Argentinian.
Of course. Yeah.
And so I'm trying to get better at... So we went to Spain. I was working on my Spanish because my girlfriend's grandma is in Australia at the moment. I had to meet her. She doesn't speak English. I don't speak Spanish.
How'd your Spanish go there?
Well, I was... Like, it's hard as a comedian. You get reviewed a lot, but this was the worst review I've ever had. So my girlfriend left me alone with her grandma for 20 minutes. So we just tried to chat. She doesn't speak English. Uh-huh. I don't speak Spanish. Uh-huh. And then afterwards... I'm also great with grandmas, by the way. It's like I'm so good. But when they can't speak English, my super powers, they're all gone. So I chatted to her for a while and then, you know, we went our separate ways. Afterwards, I said to my girlfriend, I'm like, what did your grandma think of me? And she said, and I quote, he's a very serious young man.
So that's what... That's what you want to hear.
That's because you kept asking her the directions of the train station. To our website for details on Sam's show live on November 17. Would you please thank Sam Taunton?